Hola chicos de Español 3, hoy empezamos con presentación de gramática. Go. Review the direct audio pronouns, then use them to describe trouble, cans, and tricks. Alright, let's go now with this. English grammar connection. Let me go here, like we go. Okay. Direct audio pronouns receive the action of the verb in a sentence. They answer the question whom or what about the verb. Direct audio pronouns take the place of direct object nouns. Let's see some examples. I have the passport, noun passport, pronoun it. Okay. Also, we can do that in Spanish. In Spanish, we got el pasaporte, and the direct object pronoun is lo. So what does it mean? It means that this lo, right here, is similar to this it. That is direct object pronoun. Okay, so the passport that is right here is the noun, and the passport that is right here is the noun. Okie dokie, so we got it, like the one that is replacing lo. Okay, now we're gonna see some examples. Direct object pronouns can be used to replace direct object nouns. Here is how. So with this box. Okay, in this box we're gonna be working now on here is how. Direct object pronouns. Singular. Me, te, lo, masculine, feminine, la. That is singular. Okay, now we go in plural. Nos, us, os, not very commonly used in New Spanish, masculine, los, plural, as I said before, and las, feminine. Okay, those are direct object pronouns. We're going to see more examples down. Ahora veamos algunos ejemplos aquí en este box. Miremos algunos ejemplos en este cuadro. All right. Direct object pronouns are placed directly before conjugated verbs. Before conjugated verbs. Veo a la profesora. I see the teacher. And then we place the direct object pronoun. La veo. I see her. Okay, notice that we have the direct object pronoun here at the beginning. Right? I see her. Veo a Mr. Martinez. Lo veo, because it's him. Masculine. Him, okay, that is him. All right, here we got more examples. Héctor tiene el itinerario. Héctor has the itinerario. Okay, Héctor lo tiene. I said before, here lo is referring to it, that is el itinerario. Okay, itinerary is it. That is the way it is. Okay, we're going to see more examples on the bottom of this page that says, when infinitive follows the conjugated verb, the direct object pronoun can be placed before the conjugated verb or attached to the infinitive. All right, let's see some examples. Well, there are a little basic explanation about the grammar, but the best way to learn it is just to put in practice, just to write a lot of examples and exercises about this. For example here, no voy a hacer la maleta hoy. I'm not going to pack the suitcase today. That means no la voy a hacer hoy. When we are referring to la maleta. Okay, we are referring to la maleta. So here we have that la maleta is la here. Okay, we can say here, I'm not going to pack the suitcase. This is the suitcase, go here, and then it, okay? I'm referring, changing the noun for the object pronoun. I can say, close the door, or close it, okay? So we are replacing the nouns with the direct object pronouns. We're going to see some more practice activities and exercises so you can get it. All right, vámonos a hacer algo de trabajo. All right. Ok, práctica de gramática. Práctica de gramática. Bueno, vamos a hacer un poco de práctica en este ejercicio, en esta parte de la clase, en el cual di si tienes estas cosas cuando vas de vacaciones. Say if you had this thing when you go on vacation. Discuss what you take on vacation. Example número uno. ¿Tienes el pasaporte? Do you have the passport? Ok. Sí. Or you can say no, no lo tengo. The same question. Do you have a passport? Yes, I have it. Or no, I don't have it. Okay. So the passport is lo. Práctica de gramática. Okay, chicos, vamos a hacer algunos ejercicios para poner en práctica nuestro conocimiento con respecto a los direct object pronouns. Okay, empezamos. Di si tienes estas cosas cuando vas de vacaciones. Discuss what you take on vacation. Let's do el modelo. El modelo es passport, el pasaporte. We need to identify if it is masculine or feminine, and if it is plural or singular. So we're going to identify that. Maybe you're going to say, okay, él es masculine and it's just one, so it's singular. So we're going to have the question now here. The question says, ¿tienes el pasaporte? Do you have the passport? And the person B will say, sí, lo tengo. O no, no lo tengo. Okay, because passport, the passport here is, the passport is lo, is it. Okay, the passport is it. We're going to do now activity number one. Let's try to identify these things. The number one says los videojuegos. Is it plural? Is it singular? Is it masculine? Is it feminine? Okay. So if you say that it is masculine plural, you are right. Okay, so we're gonna have the question now. Okay. The question will say, ¿tienes los videojuegos? ¿Tienes los videojuegos? And the person will say, sí, los tengo, or no, no los tengo, because it's plural masculine. All right, we can do now. Activity number two, número dos. Vamos con el dos. El dos me está diciendo el lector de DVD, de DVD player. Okay, it's a little bit hard when you don't know if it is masculine or feminine. That is a big issue when you are learning Spanish because you don't identify that. You don't have that in English. That's the reason why it'll be complicated to know it in Spanish. So, el lector de DVD. Well, basically it's L. That means that when we talk about L, you say, okay, it's masculine. El masculine, la feminine, el masculine, masculine. This is feminine plural, that's masculine plural. This is masculine plural, and this is masculine singular. Okay, once you have identified that, you're going to write the questions. Let's do number three so you can get more information about it. Okay, so let's do number three. Number three, we're going to have el libro. El libro, but what is el libro? El libro, okay. So the question will be, ¿tienes el libro? Okay. And the person will say, sí lo tengo o no, no lo tengo. You have to keep in mind that el libro is a masculine singular. Okay. And that's it. You're gonna go with the rest of it. Don't forget question and answers. Question and answers. Vamos para el siguiente ejercicio, número 7. Now we're going to be doing activity number 7. ¿Quién lo hace? Bueno, completa las oraciones con el pronombre de objeto directo para describir cómo se prepara la familia Ramos. Complete using direct object pronouns. Modelo. En el verano vamos a Costa Rica. Mis abuelos invitan. So the answer will be, Mis abuelos nos invitan. Because vamos goes for we go. So it's nos invita. Alright? We're going to see now activity número uno. I'm going to give you the first example. Here it says, hablo en español con mis abuelos. I speak Spanish with my grandparents. So, ellos me entienden muy bien. They understand me very well. They understand me very well. Because, remember, the verb goes after the direct object pronoun. Ellos me entienden a mí. Why? Because I'm talking with them. So, when I speak Spanish with them, they understand when I speak Spanish. Let's do activity number two. Activity number two, we have, mis papás no compran los boletos. Okay. Mis papás no compran los boletos. My parents do not purchase the tickets. Mis abuelos buy them. How do you say buy them? Los compran. Okay, that is direct object pronoun in this section. You can see, my dear class, that we have mis padres, los. This is los. You can write it here too. Los. Okay? Some cases, the sentence gives us more details and information about what is the best way to complete the sentence. All right, you keep on working on number 3, 4, 5, 6, up to 8. All right? Any question, raise your hand, I'll be with you to try to assist you in your activities. Let's go with the next activity. Okay, class, I understand that some people don't like to read, but that's the only way how you can improve your Spanish pronunciation. Okay, let's take a moment and we go over this conversation. Alejandro films Natalia on the set of a fake airplane. Alright? Alejandro, tú vas a tomar un vuelo a Miami. Haces cola para abordar el avión. Esperas en la puerta y miras tu tarjeta de embarque. Se la das al auxiliar de vuelo. Abordas el avión. Madre, ¿tienes sus trajes de baño? Natalia, sí, los tenemos. Alejandro, tenemos nuestros pasaportes y el itinerario. Madre, ¿pasaportes? No los necesitan. Pero en la agencia de viajes dicen... Pero no vamos a viajar a Miami. Vamos de vacaciones aquí, en Costa Rica, a Playa Hermosa. Natalia y Alejandro, ¿a la playa? ¡No! Okay. De vacaciones. On vacations. Ok. Pregúntale a tu compañero o compañera si hace estas actividades cuando está de vacaciones. Modelo. Comer hamburguesas. Hey, ¿comes hamburguesas cuando estás de vacaciones? Do you have hamburgers when you are on vacations? Sí, las como. No, no las como. ¿Y tú? Then we say hamburguesas, las hamburguesas, las, direct object pronoun. Okay. Question number one. ¿Bebes refrescos cuando estás en vacaciones? Do you drink sodas or drinks when you're on vacation? Sí, los bebo. Los bebo. Yes, I drink. Okay, bebe. ¿Escuchas música clásica cuando estás de vacaciones? Do you listen to classical music when you are on vacation? Sí, la escucho. Oh, no, la escucho. Okay, that is using the direct object pronoun.